Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Mr. P.Y.Kumbhar. Today we want to see Huffman coding. The learning outcome of this topic is, at the end of the session, student will be able to explain the concept of Huffman coding algorithm in lossless compression algorithm. The contents of these topics are introduction, after that one we want to see algorithm steps, Huffman code, that is a creating tree, Huffman coding example, after that one we want to see Huffman decoding, and after that one from this decoding we want to see Huffman coding properties. Now first, introduction. Huffman coding was firstly presented by scientist Huffman in 1952. This method attracted an overwhelming amount of research. It has been adopted in many important and commercial applications such as fax machine, JPEG and MPEG images. In Shannon-Fano encoding steps, which is, now everyone pause the video and recall the steps of Shannon-Fano encoding. Okay, it is from top to down, but in Huffman algorithm, it was opposite to the Shannon-Fano encoding, that is from bottom to up manner. Now we want to see one by one the algorithm steps of Huffman coding. Now first, initialization. In that initialization steps, put all the symbols on the list sorted according to their frequency counts. Second, repeat until the last has only one symbol left. In this case, from the list, pick up two symbols with the lowest frequency counts from a Huffman subtree that has these two symbols as a child nodes and create a parent node for them. After that one, assign the sum of the children's frequency counts to the parent and insert it into the list such that order is maintained. After that one, delete the children from the list. And third one is, assign a code word for each leaf based on the path from the root. Now we want to see Huffman code, that is creating tree. In the previous slide, whatever we see the steps of algorithm, that we want to sort it here. In this algorithm, first of all, place each symbol in the leaf. In that one, weight of the leaf is equal to the symbol of frequency. After that one, select the two trees, left and right, initially leaves. After that one, such that L and R have the lowest frequency in the trees. Create a new internal node where left child is represented by L, right child is represented by R, and new frequency is equal to the summation of frequency, that is L, plus frequency, that is R, and repeat until all the nodes merge into the one tree. Now this algorithm we can understood with the help of the example. Now we want to see one Huffman coding example. Now first of all, Huffman tree construction, this is step one. Here first of all we sort out, here we take an example of A, C, E, H and I, these are the symbols, and I want to write here the frequency of that symbols. For the A, the frequency is 3, for C, the frequency is 5, for E, the frequency is 8, and for H, the frequency is 2, and for the I, this is a frequency 7. In that example, first of all, we want to write the frequency of these symbols. After that one, we want to make a combination of these two symbols because this frequency is very low as compared to the all other symbols. Therefore, for A and H, I want to combine first. For the A frequency is 3 and for the H frequency is 2, that these two frequencies is very less as compared to these three symbols. Therefore, first of all, I will take A and H. After the combining of this A and H, that is the frequency of A is 3. The frequency of H is 2, the combining of these two symbols become as 3 plus 2 is 5. In the next step, Huffman reconstruction 3, this is the previous step which we got it, and for this next step I want to add C, because the remaining symbols in the from the previous step is C, E and I. Now if you observe, the frequency of C is 5, the frequency of E is 8, and the frequency of E is 7. Therefore I will take whichever having the low frequency. Now if you observe, in this C, E and I, the frequency of C is very low, therefore I will take here C, and adding this one 5 and the C is a 5, it becomes 10. Now in the next step, this is a one tree, and I want to make out another tree. In this one, the symbol E and I, that's the frequency is 8 and the frequency 7. I want to combine these two frequencies and it become as a 15. Now in the Huffman tree construction 5, I want to add these all the symbols into this one, whichever I got in the previous steps, that is the A, H, C, E, I, and I will add after that one. I will get 10 plus 15, that is a 25. After that one, I want to write left indicates by 1, right indicates by 0. In this way, I will do the Huffman tree construction. Now, if we observe the code for this each word, now I want to calculate the code word for the E. Now, according to the steps algorithm, I will go from bottom to top. Therefore, for the E, if you observe, E is present at the right side of this symbol, therefore it will come first 0. And after that one, it will goes to the 1. Therefore, E symbol is 01. And the similarly, we apply for I. Therefore, the apply for the I, it will come from bottom to the top, that is 0, and 0, that is 00. And for the according to that one, if you apply for the C, it will for the C, it will come for 1 and 0. For the A, it will come 1, 1, 1. And for the H, it will come 1, 1 and 0. In this way, I will construct this Huffman tree. Now, in this example, we want to take on another example that is related to the Huffman code. That is a EICAH that will be observed in the previous table, and I want to write down the encoding for input symbol S, ACE, and the output will become as, for this encoding S is, for the output A, I will write 111, that is here 111, and for the C, that is 10, this is a 10, and for the E, it will become as a 01. Therefore, this total symbol for the encoding of the input S become as 1111001. This one of the simplest steps for the encoding. Now, after that encoding, we want to see Huffman decoding. In this decoding, read the compressed file and binary tree. Use binary tree to decode the files. In that one, follow the path from root to the leaf. Now I will take an example of for the Huffman decoding one is, now I want to decode these symbols, that is 1111001, and this is a word tree. Now Huffman decoding is done with the help of this tree, and this is a decoding steps. Now if you observe here, now see one by one, now the first symbol, it will come 1. Now according to the algorithm, we want to go from bottom to the top. Therefore, the first symbol is what? 1. Here 1 means what? It will goes to the here 1 at the left side. Again, after that 1, I will write the 1, and again it will goes to the this will 1. This blue line indicates 1. And again I will go for the 1 that will indicates again, that is a blue line, that is 1. And after that one, I will get the code A. Means what? For this triple 1, I will get the code A. Again, go for the next code, that is 1. If you go from, again it will goes from bottom to the top. Again 1 will goes to the this one 1, and after that one it will goes to the 0, that is it will goes to the 0, and after that one we get the symbol, that is a C. Again that is a C symbol. Again I want to go from this 0. Again for this next code I will go from bottom to the top, that is the next code is 0, that will go to the right hand side, that will indicated by this line, this is a 0. After that one we will go for 1, that is a 1 is a code for which we want to decode, and it will go for 1, that is this one, and we get the symbol E. Means what? For the decoding purposes, if you provide this code and this binary T from this one binary tree and this code, we can decode and we get the data as ACE, that is ACE. Now from this decoding and encoding, we can easily sort out the what is the properties of Huffman coding. Now before the understanding of what is the properties, we can get it from, we can understand easily from this example. So we want to consider first example. Now from that one, we want to see Huffman code properties. Now first, here is the first property is prefix code. Now what is in the, happening in the prefix code is, no code is a prefix of another code. Now for example, for the Huffman symbol the I, here I will get the 00, and after that one for the X I will get here 001, and it is a not legal prefix code. Now this can stop as soon as complete the code found. This will be stopped. This Huffman code decoding part will be the stop when we receive the code for particular numbers. Then after that one, we want to stop there. Now, no need for end of code marker. Here, no need of require of the marker. Here, after the completion of this data, whenever I get the symbol, then we have to stop there. Therefore, here, no need end of code marker. This is a very huge, important properties for the Huffman code. Now, references for this topic are, thank you.